You are watching M.A.T.O. episode 40. It's a Tuesday of a new week. It's actually the second week of the 2013. So I was just mucking around with the new package that I received today. So this is a bunch of DCUC figures. So here I have the Ben 10 figure that I showed in the previous episode. And of course, the same prop that I also showed last week. So the new thing I have is kind of the new 52 Superman. So this is the updated Superman look. So no more red underwear. So well, you know, I kind of dig the new look. But of course, some things are still iconic. So I do miss his old suit. But, you know, I don't really have any complaints about this updated look. So I'm kind of digging it. To be honest, shoot me. You know, I haven't read any of the new 52 storylines yet. So I need to really get down to reading some of the new stuff. So, just a simple display that I did. So, I have the new 52 Superman kind of levitating as if he's going to... I kind of gave him the intent of him going to land and talk to the young boy with his skateboard. So... yeah, nothing too fancy, just a simple display. In this case, I felt that there was no need for a cutout. So, yeah. I think I would give this dude probably an 8 out of 10 on the awesomeness rating. Nothing against this figure, but, you know, as with the usual issues of DCUC figures, the cape is extremely... hard, so it's very difficult to pose. Yeah, but other than that, the sculpt, the look, the articulation is decent enough. So yeah, I give this guy 8 out of 10. Okay, so the other figure that I got in the package was the Red Robin. So Red Robin was previously released by DC Direct. I believe it was from the Kingdom Come series, one of my favorite storylines and waves. So anyway, that particular Red Robin lacked articulation. So I'm quite glad that they released this character in the recent DCUC waves. So yep, my buddy Floyd sent me the Red Robin together with the new 52 suits. So I dreamt up this display while unpacking a Red Robin. So here what I'm showing is kind of a transitioning or an evolution. So here you have Team Drake in two different periods and suits. So I have him on the leftmost as Robin, and I have him behind as his current persona, which is the Red Robin. And then I decided to get Dick Grayson in this display as well. So here Dick Grayson in the forefront is Nightwing, and behind him is his current look as the stand-in Batman. So I think this is just a very simple display, but I think it came out pretty well. So yeah, I'm looking forward to posting some pics on the A.C.B.A group. So check that out. So yeah, you know, this guy, the Red Robin, was supposed to come with a staff. When I contacted Floyd, he said he misplaced it. So anyway, no worries. If I do need Red Robin with a staff, I'll probably get it from this, maybe from the Deathstroke figure, or I'll post him with some other accessories. Not a big deal. So, yep, I think I'll probably give this guy an 8.5. I think his suit is pretty dope. Or maybe on second thought, I'll give him an 8, because I just realized he kind of has this skirting around his legs. So it's going to limit his posability. But yeah, so I think similarly to Soups, you know, because of the minor things about the cape and the skirtings, so it makes posing a bit more challenging. So that's why I deducted 2 points from my grading. So yep, that's pretty much it for my current batch of stuff. So I'm going to try to figure out some display for the A.C.B.A showdown hosted by AJ Frost. So I have to dream up some display pretty soon. The deadline is on the 16th, which is next week. On top of that, there's recent updates about the A.C.B.A World Championships. You know, Book released a video sharing that there's poor turnout. So people, you know, I hope that by the time this video is released, that is not true, that the championship is not cancelled, and I look forward to participate. So guys, hopefully, you know, you guys show up and show your support for the community and the tournament. So yep, stay tuned. Hopefully I have more goodies to share for towards the rest of, I mean during the rest of the week. Yep, that's pretty much what I have to share about the today's haul. So stay tuned. New package arrived in the mail today. So this is the amazing Spider-Man figure from the movie. So this is a select figure. So it comes with the backdrop, which is just a very simple wall with the AC unit and a window. So unlike the Black Cat set, the base is a very basic one. No special moving parts, unlike that particular set where the window opens and closes. But nonetheless, a pretty nice backdrop, and the Spidey fits quite well on the pack, and he stays there. So this is kind of the money shot I had in mind. Maybe just let me zoom on his face. Yep, so for a select figure, pretty dope. The articulation is surprisingly good. Nice joints on the arms and legs. Not much of an ab crunch, but in this case, it works. And I kind of like the mask on this guy with the yellow eyelids. And this webbing I got from another Spidey set. So I just have him in kind of this pose. Pretty nice, you know, I kind of like the outcome. I wish the backdrop was taller and wider, but I guess in this case it does kind of work with the pictures I took. So yeah, I'm quite happy with this figure and set. You know, this is something I got from Brandon Phillips. He cut me a very good deal. And yeah, on top of that, it actually comes with interchangeable hands. So here he's with his typical, you know, web slinging pose, and then you can change both hands into closed fists. So I'm doing something different also. You know, usually I use my ceiling lights with my displays, but today I'm kind of using this USB lamp. Not very obvious here because I intentionally got a black lamp, but it's an LED light and it's rechargeable, so pretty dope. So I'm quite satisfied with how the pick for this guy turned out. So check it out on the ACBA Facebook group. So yep, I think that's pretty much my haul and display for this week. So do stay tuned and take care. Ciao.
That's crispy.